Let's complete now the creation of a new part. I'll ask you to actually open a macro project. Inside the macro project, we will create a new page for the power distribution block that we just created. So we'll actually go under power distribution, and this is where we'll create a new page. Page, let's say, 34, and this is a power distribution block, the test.power distribution block that we created earlier. So once you open this page here, you can actually copy over the portion of the schematics we did earlier from page number 2, open in a new window if you want to. Here we have it full page, we copy this portion, control C, control V, right mouse click, copy, move over to this here, right mouse click, paste, and we just paste it in here. Okay, we can paste it exactly in the same spot, we don't have to necessarily renumber it, and this is our first portion. Second portion would be actually the rotated variant. So we copy, paste, control C, control V, there we go, we can actually renumber it if we want to. We take this, we rotate, we by now know how to do this, rotate, and then we actually flip. So there we go. So we have connection 1, 4, 2, 5, and so on. Good. This is going to be basically my first macro schematic variant A, schematic variant B, and now I'm going to draw the component as for the representation type panel layout. So I'm going to ask you to actually look up the real component and we'll actually draw it, okay? So we'll draw first a square. This square here, I want it to be the size of the real component. So it's going to be 60 and 45 millimeters, okay? Now, from here, I'm going to ask you, of course, put it down, draw a few circles. Remember, you have some big connections here. When I say big connections, these are basically the L1, L2, L3. They're actually fairly big. Oh, where's the center? The center is actually there. So probably better if I go down to a 2 millimeter, place this dead center. Now, the connections on the secondary side are a bit smaller. So you can actually use the duplicate feature here to actually put 3 more, actually even 1 more if you want to. So copy, duplicate from here to here, same distance, right? Duplicate from here to here. I'm in design mode right now. So here, duplicate from here. Let's move down to this one. And then again, duplicate from here going down to here. Okay, you got your component. Now let's assign the macros. The macros are actually macro boxes we have to draw around the components. Here is one, here is one, and here is one. So let's start. This one here, we'll actually put it in distribution and we'll call it power distribution block, PDB, maybe in capital letters, .ema. Okay, that's basically the name of my macro. Variant A is the first variant. I'm going to copy this, paste it over to this one here, but it's going to be variant B, multi-line representation. Now, of course, the box can be a little bit bigger, so we can read a little bit better what happens, right, here. And the last one, but not least, is this one here. This one will be the same name, yet it will be a panel layout. Why panel layout? Because this is the view that will be used when I'm placing the panel layout. Now, of course, once this is done, you can select them all, run the utility, generate macros automatically. Answer no, it's going to generate this macro. And then you can go to your parts management and you can find your test.pdb that you created earlier and you can complete it. So here we have the part. We can fulfill here the data, the commercial data. We can go here to the mounting data, and we can fill it out and say, okay, this is exactly the size of my component. Then we can go here to technical data. We can pick up the macro we just created. This macro was created in power, right? Distribution, and it was called PDB. There we go. Now, do I need to do more than this? No, I don't have to. I could, of course, fill out even more information if I have any kind of documentation that is relative to this. I could spend some time on a function template here, but I don't really have to. Important is the size, the technical data here, and the rest of the information. Now, of course, it's going to ask me to complete, and we'll be ready to place this component on a panel layout